certainly we should be worried. And fellow countrymen and women, I want to speak to you as a lifelong health professional who cares about our health, about your health, about my health. The COVID situation in the country, as you have just heard, is bad. Many people are getting sick. Some pass through it without even knowing. Some get very sick and die. Even those who recover, they remain with complications which we still do not understand, such as becoming diabetic, becoming hypertensive, and getting other diseases which we still do not understand. So the situation is bad, it's grim, and the disease is within us. You don't know who has got it and who does not have it.
Okay, when you say the disease is within us, one of the things that they have continued to emphasize is prevention, 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 wearing of face masks, social distancing. But the issue of face masks continues to be one of what is the right face mask to wear, how to wear it. In my hands, I have two face masks, a cloth face mask, and I have the N95, which seems to be at the top of the list of the safest face masks, I beg your pardon. But tell us about the safety of a face mask and how to wear it.
So face masks are believed to be the single most effective way of preventing catching COVID, particularly when the virus is floating in the air or it is coming from people who are near you who are infected. Now, there are many different types of face masks. The first thing to say is that face masks are safe. I have heard stories of people saying that when I wear a face mask, I will get a headache, I will get this disease and this. I am a surgeon. I spent the first 30 years of my life in the operating theater, wearing a mask all the time. I've never heard of anyone who became sick because he was wearing a mask. So please, let's not look at masks as a hazard to our health. So now, the important thing about masks, mine is here, but I'm not wearing it now because I'm far away from Rita enough, and they also say they want to see my face properly. So wear your mask to cover your nose and your mouth. And when you speak, please put on your mask when you are with people who are not like members of your family. I see many people, including big politicians, when it's time to speak, they bring down their mask. That is wrong. You can speak with your mask and people can hear you very well. And don't wear a mask which fits so tight that you cannot speak. But cloth masks are okay, provided you wash them regularly and dry them and keep them in a clean place. So these other masks are expensive. I don't expect most Ugandans to be able to afford this type of masks, but the cloth masks which are all over the place are safe to wear, and please wear them all the time when you are in crowds.
Okay. And lastly, as we wrap up our conversation, talking about immunity boosters as another way of preventing yourself from getting the COVID-19 infection, let's talk about what is too much going to the extreme, because many people mixing the lemons, the acids, has brought people going to the hospital with getting ulcers and all that.
So just to make sure that in case you catch COVID, your body is prepared to fight it. And our bodies are designed to protect ourselves from infections. The most important thing is to eat well. Have enough water inside yourself. When I say eat well, most African foods are fine. You know, this gobe, ebo, kalo, and beans and vegetables, that is what you should eat. Also fruits, if you can lay your hand on them. But don't allow yourself to be eating this fried food like muchomo and so on. African foods are very good indeed. And I also want to tell our people that the government of Uganda has issued the National Community Engagement Strategy. And this strategy is aimed at establishing in every village, every LC1, a COVID village task force. This message has already gone to all the districts. So please move and establish village COVID task forces whose job is going to be to answer the question, How are we in this village? Who has gone out? Who has come in? Who is not well? And there are village health teams in every village. There is also LC1 chair in every village. We would like to see the LC1 chair be responsible for this committee, working together with this committee, the Secretary for Women Affairs, the Secretary for Defense, also bring in community development people, cultural leaders, religious leaders, and watch who is bringing COVID into our village. And who has got COVID in our village, how can we support that person? That is going to be the way to get on top of COVID in Uganda.
Well, thank you so much.